national development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low points. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing standing national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to the control, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by PEACE Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. PEACE Education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability for psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. Has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value systems. PEACE Education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacity and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. Peaceful interests. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low points. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing standing national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to the control, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by PEACE Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. This education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability of psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value systems. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. It's full interest. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low costs. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing standing national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be controlled, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by Peace Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. This education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability of psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value systems. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low costs. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing standing national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be control, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by PC Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. This education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the instances of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability for psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral and spiritual value systems. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low costs. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing stand-in national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be control, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by PC Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. This education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability for psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value systems. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. Peaceful interest. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low points. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing standing national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be controlled, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by Peace Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. This education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability for psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral and spiritual value system. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. Peaceful interest. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low points. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing standing national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be controlled, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by Peace Education have accepted pedagogy too of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. This education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the instances of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability of psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value systems. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low costs. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing stand-in national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be control, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by Peace Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. This education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability of psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value systems. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low costs. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing stand-in national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the state to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be controlled, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by PEACE Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. PEACE Education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability for psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value system. This education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal non-violence capacities and adopt a multicultural approach to changing both people and their communities. National development is thus deeply affected in business investment operating under very low costs. In restoring public confidence in the state's ability to manage commercial disputes, intra-group and inter-community conflicts, many governments and states are establishing and institutionalizing standing national capacities for conflict prevention and resolution as extensions of their national governance framework. In Nigeria, specifically in the southeastern part of the country, cultism in schools, proliferation of arms and violent conflict, coupled with illicit trafficking and trading in valuable mineral resources and commodities, has compounded the plight of the states, teachers, and students. And just opposed to this is the growing low capacity of the states to generate employment, to provide welfare support, and support, importantly, and to support, most importantly, to be controlled, discipline, or the avenue to rehabilitate juveniles. Similarly, with the diminishing and limited access to resources, many parents have struggled to meet the needs of their children and consequently face tremendous challenges in monitoring them. With scanty access to education, many young people and children have become alienated from the state and mainstream society. It has resulted in the creation of a vulnerable pool of young people with zero guidance on moral and ethical principles for constructive social change and development within their societies. A viable intervention option is the platform provided by PEACE Education as a tested pedagogy tool of action for conflict transformation and conflict prevention that is accessible and beneficial to young people. PEACE Education aims at promoting a culture of peaceful coexistence and preventing the incidences of violent conflict. Since its development and global acceptability for psychosocial transformation of children and youths, this impact on success has been acknowledged and continually adapted and adopted across countries and communities. It has gained popularity and prominence as a character-building intervention based on human, civic, moral, and spiritual value system. PEACE Education seeks to provide young people with the knowledge and skills required to ensure the promotion of positive social life skills and attitudes that will lead to a culture of violence and foster social cohesion. It is an empowering process that seeks to effect change through the development of personal nonviolence capacities and adopts a multicultural approach to changing both